Hi Sagittarius, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love lives or your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Sagittarians, it's a month of eclipses, both lunar as well as solar, and depending on which part of your chart, your personal chart, the eclipse is going to be aspecting, that is where growth and change is being asked of you. Now, eclipses carry a signature of change. They shake us up, they turn us around, and they ask us to adapt to the changing conditions. And the house in which a particular eclipse, either lunar or solar, is aspecting, that's the area of our life where you're being asked to grow beyond anything that we have previously ever known. And eclipses also tend to bring about old patterns and to show us how far we have come and how ready we are willing to grow more. It takes a lot of courage to put yourself out there for the world to see, to speak your truth, to let your choices be known, to be vulnerable and to be judged. But this is the time where you can bring about that change in your life. This is something that you can do, Sagittarians. So if something has not been working for the longest, this is the time where you can move ahead. And just stand in the center, stand by your friends, stand close to the people who love you and take care of you. And operate from and make choices from the deepest part or the truest values that you hold. So let's have a look as to where the eclipses are happening for you. On the 7th, we have a lunar eclipse that is there in your house of communication, sibling, and short distance travel. And lunar eclipses are about closure. It's about something which is coming to an end. And this is a time where it can be that a certain project is coming to an end. Maybe you are just... finishing touches onto a project that you've been working on. It can also be that a lot of you are having a lot of discussions, negotiations, and you're pushing your case forward. There could be a lot of meetings. You could be meeting a lot of clients, or you could be, you could be sending out long mails about projects, you could be being reviewed, you could be having to travel a lot for work. It also has to do with your sibling, so it could be that either a sibling is visiting in town, maybe the sibling requires some help or maybe some mediation from your side, or it can also be that a sibling is being a cause of concern. In certain cases, it could be that you could be leaning on your sibling as well. On the 13th, we have Mercury that goes retrograde in your house of career and reputation, and it is retrograde till about 6th of September. It's a time to get reorganized, it's a time to retweak, relook at anything that has to do with your work. And it's very important to be careful about any kind of official communication that you're sending out, be it SMSs, be very careful as to whom it is that the SMSs are marked. Be very sure about the communication on emails that is happening, that you know you're absolutely clear and specific as to what is it that you're asking the person for. And it's a time also to rework on maybe deals that have not worked before. So relook, retweak. Because this also has to do with your reputation, be very careful about that you don't suffer from a foot and mouth disease. Don't end up just saying something, which could just turn into a huge scandal, and you know, it could be something really silly, but it just sort of catches fire because it's very gossipy energy as well. On the 21st, we have a solar eclipse that is there in your house of expansion. It's a house of higher mind and consciousness, and your ruling planet Jupiter also rules this. So quite a wonderful placement, because great time to be traveling, and you love Sagittarians. I think it just sort of expands your soul. It makes you just sort of that thirst, that hunger for knowledge gets satiated only by travel for you. So it's a wonderful time, and I think a lot of you are going to also be imbibing knowledge. You're going to be learning as well as you travel. So they could be work-related long-distance trips. It could also be that you're trying to understand as to how people operate in different countries, cultures, and how it is that you can implement the same at your own workplace as well. On the 23rd, we have a sun that is there in your house of career. It's a lovely time. You could be feeling very confident. You're going to be feeling very, very sure of yourself. And there's a sense of being very courageous, but whether it's a work decision that you have to take or even your own position as to where it is that you stand in the company or amongst your team or, you know, how you're looked at. So you're going to be exuding a lot of confidence, a lot of courage. And also you're being asked during this time that if in the past you have sort of hesitated to take a risk, this is a time where you should take a risk and not worry so much about failure. On the 27th, we have Venus that is joining Mars in the solar eclipse that is there in your house of expansion and higher mind and spirituality. So fantastic placement again. Mars, of course, could bring about a little bit of restlessness. You know, it could just make you a little bit agitated, and it could also make you feel as to why is it that things are not moving, you know, as fast as you feel that they should. But Venus being over there, because she also rules money, it's a time where it could be that a lot of money is at stake. Maybe the financial and the legal negotiations are going to be taking time and they need to be looked at very carefully. So with the new opportunity that it is presenting, for some of you it can be that it's a new workplace in another country. For some of you, it can mean that you are being invited. Either it could be as simple as maybe going for a conference outside. So keep all your windows open and ensure that you have your best foot out and that you're networking. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Sagittarians. I'll see you again soon. And thank you so much for watching.